Good morning. I'd like to welcome you who brave this cold to Bainbridge United Methodist Church, both those of you who are here and also those who are watching online, as well as those who will be watching later. So I wanted to say something about welcome to this warm day, because I thought it's all going to be perspective, right? So I got on the internet and I'm looking about, okay, well, where's all the cold spots? And it's pretty sad when you're in like the top three of cold spots on the earth. So Winnipeg is colder than we are, so we're warmer than Winnipeg. So there we go. Anchorage is warmer, though, so that's pretty bad. You may hear a little bit in my voice today. I've been sick all week. I don't think I'm sick anymore. I think it's turned into an upper respiratory, but just to be on the safe side, I won't be shaking hands at the end. I'm 90% sure it's an upper respiratory. So, announcements, we have the cold care kit building, I guess, right after church. About 20 minutes, 30 minutes or so if you want to stay. The more people who help, the quicker that it goes. So it's already set up in the fellowship hall. And there will be record of giving available after church. It'll be at the welcome table if you're interested in that. So would like to go to our call to worship. And it's going to be page 881 in your hymnals. We're going to do the Apostles' Creed this morning. The top of 881. And let's read this in unison. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, and the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please stand if you are able and join us for a hymn.
Thank you.
Please be seated. If I could have the kids come up. Down there, folks. And can you grab the prayer thing, please? Do me a favor. Turn around for me. There's a box on the table back there. Can you grab it, please? Sorry, I don't know your name. Oh, there you go. Thank you, Maddie. What's your name, bud?
Gunner.
Gunner, that's right. Hey, bud. All right. Anybody know what this is?
Play-Doh.
Everybody used it before?
Yeah.
All right. Each one of you are going to get one of these. Pass it around. What do you use Play-Doh for? What do you use Play-Doh for? Good. What do you use it for?
Play with it.
Play with it. Making stuff. Very good. What all can you make with Play-Doh?
Animals.
Cookies. What?
Cookies.
Not to eat, but yeah, you can.
I use it for my dolls.
Your dolls? Okay. You make stuff with it, don't you? So when you have Play-Doh, and I grabbed blue, so hopefully it doesn't get all over me here. When you have Play-Doh, if you can get it out, you make stuff. Have you ever heard of a book in the Bible called Genesis? You know what Genesis is? You know what Genesis talked about right at the very beginning? Genesis talked about how God made the earth. And when you look at Play-Doh, what's that right there? Anything? It's formless. That's the way the earth was before God made it. Before God made all this stuff, there was nothing. Similar to Play-Doh, where there was nothing there other than what God made. And when God made the heavens, the earth, the sun, the moon, the water, the fish, all the other animals, what else did he make after that?
Us.
Very good. And just like with Play-Doh, he formed us, but what was the difference between us and everything else? I'll give you a hint. We're one of the few creatures here on earth that also makes stuff. So what makes us different? God created us in his image. So we have aspects of God in us. You ever thought about that? That we are a reflection of a minuscule little part of God. That's why we can make things and do other stuff that the other creatures on earth can't. So as you play with that Play-Doh this week or during the service, or try not to get it on anything, think about how God made you and think about how God made everything else in this world. Let's pray. Lord Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you that you made us. We thank you that you made this world for us. Lord, and we thank you that we can reflect a little piece of you each and every day. Lord, we thank you for these young people here. Lord, we ask that you bless them as they grow. Lord, and please reveal yourself to them each and every day. Let them grow in you. Let them know you. Let them know your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. Thanks, folks. Yeah, you take the Play-Doh. We come to our offering and prayer time this morning. I want to remind you that you can give in the plate back in the rear of the sanctuary. You can give online, or you can send a donation into the church. Your tithes, offerings, and just donations do help this church, do help us pay all the stuff, and help us do the ministries that we were ultimately called here to do. During our time of prayer, there are a lot of prayer requests on, this is the flat version, but on your bulletin today, many of which are for healing. And I also want to add in that we need to pray for those who are remembering loved ones at this time of year. Pray for them and their comfort and their peace as they gain the understanding. Pray for understanding of the diagnoses that come, and as well as praise for the new lives that have been born and all the blessings that we have. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord God, as we come before you, Lord, we know you are our creator. We know that you have created everything. Everything in this world is of you. Lord, and we thank you for that. Lord, we thank you that for whatever reason you created us. And though that this world be broken, we thank you that you are here with us to guide us, to comfort us, to hold us, to love us. Lord, we lift up all those who are on our hearts, on our minds, who need healing, who need comfort, who need understanding, who need your grace. Lord, and we praise you for all the ways that you have acted in our lives, both the ways that we know are happy and joyous, and Lord, we praise you for those ways you have acted in our lives that we didn't understand at the time, but know that they are good. Lord, we praise you for everything. We lift up all this as we pray that prayer that your Son taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Please stand if you're able for our song of preparation. Please be seated. Our scripture today is the beginning, Genesis 1, 1 through 5. When God began to create the heavens and the earth was about without shape or form. It was dark over the deep sea, and God's wind swept over the waters. God said, "Let there be light," and so light appeared. God saw how good the light was. God separated the light from the darkness. God named the light day and the darkness night. There was evening and there was morning, the first day. The word of God for the people of God. Did you know that God is a baseball fan? That's why this passage starts with, "In the beginning." Yeah, I know. That was kind of a dad joke. Actually, more of an Our Father joke. That one didn't go over at all. Wow. I worked on that all week. Do you ever wonder if God laughs? Does he smile? We know he gets angry. We've read about how that worked out for folks, making that whole golden calf thing. I personally believe that God has most of the emotions that we do. We are made in his image. And it all starts with God. We hear this, but do we feel it? Do we feel that everything actually starts with God? Do we know that? Are we as sure of that, that everything starts with God, as we are that when we put our foot down, the ground will be there? You see, taking that step, just one foot in front of the other, is an act of faith. Now, it's one that we don't really think about anymore because we've been doing this for a while now. But think about those times when the little kids, they start walking and how tenuous they are as they step. Have you ever experienced that as an adult? There was a time when I was in the military that we did what's called a field exercise, which means we go out in the field, basically in the middle of nowhere, we put up tents or little shelters, and then we do stuff out in the field. And in doing that, on this one, we did what was called land navigation exercise. A land navigation exercise is where you have a map, a terrain map that shows you all the features of the terrain, and you literally have to go from one point to the other. They give you these points, and we did it somewhere in southeastern Ohio. I've tried for years to remember where it was, but I was asleep on the bus until we got there, so I can't remember. And literally, they have these posts set up in the middle of the woods with numbers on them, and that's where you find your point. And the way it works is you get your coordinates to one point, and then you have coordinates from that point. So if you don't find your first one, you're not finding your next one. So we're doing this field exercise, and of course it's the military, so you don't do it in the day, you do it in the middle of the night. You're not allowed to use flashlights, so you're literally walking in the dark, and you're doing it individually, so you're by yourself. There's other people around, but you're doing it as an individual thing. And I remember I was going to this one point, and I had plotted it out on the map, knew where I was basically going in this direction. And I knew that as I got closer to the point, the terrain lines got really close together. Now, if you know what map reading or that type of map is, if the lines get really close together, that means the terrain either goes straight up or straight down. So I'm going into this tree line, and when I got into the tree line, the moon went away, so it's pitch black. And I'm literally taking half steps and then probing with my feet as I'm going, because I can't see. And pretty soon, there's no ground. So then I go over this way, and there's no ground. And I can't literally find the ground in front of me or beside me. So at that point, I go ahead and pull out my light. Now it's a red light, that way you don't blind everything, because it was a safety issue at that point. And I find that I'm standing at the edge of a cliff. Now to me, in the middle of the night, at pitch black, and the fact that I almost fell down it, this cliff was bottomless. Like, it didn't have a bottom. I would have fallen straight through the earth. In reality, it was probably about 40 feet. But I do know that had I fallen down that, I would not have been found until who knows when. How many of us walk through life with God that way? We say God's there for us, but yet we still inch our way through, keeping one foot and trying to find where God is in our life and our decisions. We don't walk with the same grace and confidence that we would if we're walking downtown on the sidewalk, where we know that that next step is going to be solid on concrete. We need to walk with that kind of confidence that God will take care of us, that God is there for us, that God will guide us each and every day. And when we do that, we not only gain confidence in God ourselves, deepen our faith, deepen our trust in God, but it can also translate to those around us. When I was a youth pastor at Walnut Street, it was late November, early December of 2020. Y'all might remember that year. There was this thing going around. So the pandemic, well, this is like the beginning-ish of the pandemic. We had had it a few months. People were still dying a lot. We did not have a vaccine yet. That was still several months away. And we've been having youth for a few months at that point. And somehow, like we always did during that time, we got on the subject of COVID. Now, you have to remember one thing. Through my other careers, God has saved my life in too many occasions to count. I can't tell you how many times God has saved me. So because of that, my faith is very strong. I pray that my faith is actually as strong as I think it is. Literally, I am standing here before you because God has kept me from getting shot, stabbed, beaten, and blown up. Literally. He has saved me from my own destruction along with the destruction of the world. So my faith is strong. So that evening, I'm in the youth room. Sunday evening, late November, early December 2020. The subject of COVID comes up, and I say, because the kids are scared. Everybody was scared. And I said to the kids, I said, look, I know I'm going to get COVID. I might get sick. I might get very sick. I might be hospitalized. I might be on a ventilator. But I know that God will get me through it. Because at that time, I was a point in my life. I wasn't ordained yet. But I knew that God had brought me that far, and I knew that God was not going to allow me to be ended by COVID because he had more for me. Didn't know what, but I knew at that time that that was the case. Well, I won't call myself a prophet, but within a few weeks, I got COVID. Around Christmas time, 2020. Actually, I was talking to Kate about that the other day because we have a picture of at Walnut Street, it was a tradition that your family would always take a picture in front of the Christmas tree on Christmas Eve service. And there's a picture of just Kate and I at the tree on Christmas Eve that 2020, because Noelle wasn't feeling too good, so she stayed home. Well, we all had COVID and we didn't know it. So we get Christmas COVID, and we're down for several weeks. We had it pretty bad. Nobody was hospitalized. A few weeks later, after recovery, I'm back in the youth room. Again, somehow the subject of faith comes up. And this young man, I'd forgotten all about it, said, you know you were right. What are you talking about? I said, you said you were going to get COVID. I said, and you said God would pull you through. And he did. You were right. It See, God is the beginning of everything. We just have to have faith that He actually is. Well, He's the beginning of everything good. In the scripture, verse 2 says this. The earth was without shape or form. It was dark over the deep sea, and God's wind swept over the waters. The earth being without shape, it was dark. And then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. Next, God, through the Holy Spirit, that's the wind, in verse 2, begins to form the world, to shape the world, to set up this perfect world. Now, I'm not a person who says that it happened in 7 days. I don't know. It could have, absolutely. Yeah, could have. I don't know. When I get to paradise, if I care then, and I read the history of the world, and I find out that, yep, it happened in 7 days, great, that's awesome. But if I read it and it says that God set up this system which formed the earth over a period of millions of years, and to make it better for us to understand in our primitive human minds, they called it a day so they could get through it, that's good too. The larger point is, God created everything. Don't know how. I don't care how He wrote it down. I wouldn't understand it. God formed the earth. He made the sun, the stars, the moons. He created plants, fish, and animals. He set up this system that this planet can sustain itself through weather patterns, the water cycle. Even the plants give off what the animals need, and the animals give off what the plants need to survive. And this all started with God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. Now here's the thing. Evil is here too. Evil being the absence of God. Now evil can take various forms, but at its crux, evil is not God. Not something started by God. But God can overcome evil, we know that. Your faith can overcome the evil in your life, your faith in God. In verse 2, Genesis talks about the earth being formless and dark. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. Now, commonly, we think of this light being called forth as the sun. But if you look a couple passages down, verse 14 and following, God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night. They will mark events, sacred seasons, days, and years. They will be the lights in the dome of the sky to shine on the earth." And that's what happened. God made the stars and two great lights, the larger light to rule over the day and the smaller light to rule over the night. God put them in the dome of the sky to shine on the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from darkness. God saw how it was good. The light in verse 2, I believe, was not the sun. God talks about the sun, Genesis talks about the sun a couple of verses later. I believe that light called forth was Christ. God called forth Himself to begin forming the earth from His absence, from the evil, dark formlessness that it was. God called forth the light, Christ, His own goodness, to clear away the absence of Him, the evil. And from this absence, God, the light, Christ, God Himself began to form this earth from nothingness to goodness. And then God got to His ultimate creation, the creation that only after creating did He say that everything was very good. He formed us. Not just humans, but humans in His own image. We aren't just another animal out there. We were formed in the image of God Himself. And since we are formed in His image, we have, or can have, a small, minuscule little portion of God's traits. So I believe He does laugh. I believe He does cry. I believe God gets angry. I believe God loves. And I believe that God does everything. Everything. Forming the earth, creating the water, the fishes, the plants, animals, us. He did all of this out of love. He did this wanting connection, wanting us to love Him also. And we messed it up. We mess it up every day. But here it is. The universe began with God. We began with God. But do you begin with God? Is God, Christ, and the Holy Spirit, are they guiding you each and every day with each and every decision? Sure, you're here, but do they guide everything you do? That's tough. Really is. Really tough. Is your faith such that you know that God is there for you, just as that sidewalk is when you step? Are you sure? Are you that sure in God? That's where you have to start. You have to start there in building that trust each and every day. And the more you build, the more you're assured that that step is there, the deeper your faith will become. You see, just as the earth was without form and void, so are we. Just as it took days, years, some period of time for God to form the earth, so too does it take time for us to be perfected in God. But this doesn't begin until we begin. We begin with God, Christ, and the Holy Spirit. And if you're already beyond the starting gate, great, that's awesome. You can get deeper. You can gain more faith. You can gain that unshakable faith by starting and continuing with God. As my wife recently told me, actually, my wife recently told me this week while I was writing this sermon, her having no idea what this was about, to take a step in faith. Step out in faith. Raise your foot and step, knowing that God is there in your next decision. Raise your foot and step, knowing that God is there with that medical diagnosis. Raise your foot and step, knowing that He is there in your hopelessness and despair. Raise your foot and step, knowing that beyond, truly beyond, any earthly measure, that God is there for you to love you more than you can ever love Him back. Raise your foot and step, loving yourself, forgiving yourself, just as God does. So make 2024 a year to start with and continue with God, to grow deeper in your faith by taking those steps with Him, knowing that He, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, are and will be there for you. Let it be so. Sunday for a preaching sermon. As we come to our time of communion, let us pray. Lord God, we thank You. We thank You that You are there for us even when we don't know it. We thank You that You are there for us, Lord, and we thank You that You sent Your Son to be the sacrifice for our sins. Lord, we know we have sinned against you, and we ask that you forgive us of those sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And on that night before Jesus' arrest, while they were eating, Jesus took the bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Eat. This is my body broken for you." And then he took the cup. And when he had blessed it and given thanks for it, he said, "Drink from it, all of you, for the forgiveness of sins. This is my blood." Holy Spirit, we ask that you bless these elements of bread and juice. We ask that you transform them through the mystery of faith into the body and blood of Christ, so that we may be transformed, so that we may be rejuvenated in the love of Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. We practice open table, which means whether you've been here forever or you've been here a day, you can partake in the gift of communion. Jesus gave us this gift so that we may remember him and be renewed by him each and every day, and as often as we may gather. I'm going to serve the musicians, and then be open. you would please stand for our final hymn. Take time to be holy. Set apart. Set apart yourself from God. Set apart yourself from the world. Take that time to start with God each day. Start with God so that you build trust in Him and faith in Him. And then you can take that faith to others. Lord God in heaven, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your Son. We thank you for your Spirit. We thank you that you love us so much that you allow us to be set apart from the world. We ask that you guide us this week. Ask that you guide us each and every day. And Lord, let us start and step out in faith with you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have a good week, church.